Hello and welcome to this video tutorial. Gareth here from tastytutes.com. In this tutorial, I'm going to discuss and demonstrate how to export documents from InDesign out as PDFs. Later, I'll be demonstrating in depth how to export PDFs ready for print. In this video, we will be exporting the three documents we made previously on this course: a business card, a letterhead, and a 12-page brochure. In this video, I will be covering two scenarios where we may want to export PDFs. One, export for a client preview, and two, export ready for print. Now, as you make progress with your work in InDesign, there may be occasions where you may want to export to show a client the progress of a document on screen or for a quick rough printout. So with the project folder open, navigate to the Finished Examples folder, into the PDF export, into Low Preview, and open Brochure Preview version 1. So here is a PDF example of the brochure document we created earlier in the course. This is an example we may send over email for a preview or print out for a rough example. Here it shows the design clearly, and as we scroll down, we can see the spreads together. Now, if you're new to this course and wish to take a look at this PDF example, you can get access to this in the project folder. Download link is in the description. Now, once the project is complete, you will then want to export the document ready to be sent to the printers to print out the document to a high standard, and perhaps fold and staple for booklets, books, and brochures. With the project folder open, navigate to the Finished Examples folder, into the PDF export, into High Print, and open Brochure Print. Now, this is an example of the document we will send to the printers. Here, it's very different from the previous example. Here, we can see all the marks and guides necessary for the printers. And as we scroll down, we can see each page is separate. So what you will find is that the requirements for both preview and print-ready PDFs are very different. When exporting in InDesign, there are a few things you need to keep in mind for various instances. So to begin, let's open the three documents we created previously. So with the project folder open, navigate to the My Projects folder, open the WorkDocs folder, and open your InDesign files. If you have been following along, you should have the business card, letterhead, and brochure here. Now, if you're new to this course and wish to follow along, you can download the project folder and get access to the files I have prepared earlier. Link is in the description. With the project folder open, navigate to the Finished Examples folder, open the ID docs, and open the InDesign docs. So with the documents open, let's make a start. And I'll cover the first export scenario. Number one, export for client preview. So to demonstrate this, I'll use the brochure document as an example. So in this instance, I have made substantial progress with my document, and now I want to show my work to the client and get feedback and make any changes or corrections. So I need to export this in such a way that will be clear to the client. I want to send a version over email and print off a rough copy to show. So I'll come up to File, scroll down and click Export. Upon click, up will pop a window asking where I would like to save. On this occasion, I'll navigate to my project folder and aim to export it in the PDF export folder. Now, before I click save, I need to pay close attention to the bottom of the window. For the format option, I need to click this and select PDF for print. Then I'll come up and name this document Brochure Preview 1. Once happy, I'll press save. Upon click, up will pop the export option. So it's in this menu we can customize all the settings for our PDF export. So looking over on the left, we are currently looking at the general option. As we click down, we can customize other options, which we will be looking at shortly. So starting on general, from the top, we have the PDF preset. Now this document contains lots of high resolution images. If we are sending this print over email for a quick preview, then we could consider using the smallest file size option. Using this option will compress any images inside the document down to minimize the file data size. However, doing this will generate slightly pixelated and blurry images, but still clear and legible. If you click High Quality, then this will export your images to the optimum quality. Your file size will be substantially larger, but the images will be clear. So you have a choice here. If it's just a preview, then you could consider small quality. On this occasion, I'll click Small File Size, as I'm going to send this over email, and I want to keep it nice and light. So next, I'm going to focus on pages. Now here we can specify if we want to export the entire document, or perhaps just a particular page, or part of the document. Let's say the client just wants to see pages 2, 3, 6, and 7. Then we can click Range and specify it in the box to the right. I can type 2-3, 6-7, and so on. Upon exporting, only those pages will be contained. On this occasion, I'll select All. Now, under Range, we have an option, Pages or Spread. Now, currently, we have a booklet brochure document set up in InDesign. Each page is a single page, even though we have spread. If we choose Pages, each page will be exported separately. Now, because we want to send this to the client for preview, it would be best to export this as Spread. So I'll click Spread. So below this, we have further options. Here, I'm going to make sure View PDF after exporting is checked. This will mean it will appear after exporting, which is quite convenient. Since I'm sending this over email, I'll click the Optimize for Fast Web View. For export layers, I'll choose Visible and Printable Layers. For now, I do not need to pay much attention to the bottom options at this point. So over on the left, I'll click Compression. Now by clicking the Smallest File Size preset at the top, InDesign will define values here for compression. Here we can see the values that will be applied when we export. Now, if we wish to customize these, we can enter in new values, but on this occasion, I'll just leave it as it is. So next, I'll click Marks and Bleeds. Now, this option is important for when you come to print your document. When we set up the document, we specified various options. Now, because this PDF is only for a preview, I'm not going to assign any marks or bleeds to this. I don't want anything to distract the client in the PDF. So on this occasion, we do not need to pay too much attention to the other options. So back in general, once I'm doubly sure I have my settings correct, I'll click Export. Upon click, InDesign will render the PDF and it will appear like so. So as I begin to scroll down, we can see the brochure spreads nicely placed together. This is a good example for the client to view. Even though we used compression here, the images are still quite legible. So if we now come into the project folder and into my project folder, into the PDF exports, we can see the file there. If I take a look at the file information, we can see that this document is only 574 kilobytes, so perfect to email. Now we could also use this PDF to print out a rough copy to get a feel for the layout on paper at actual size. This PDF has been set to spread, so we'll make a nice rough printout. Okay, so that's the best way to export a PDF to send for a client preview or print out a rough copy. Now, once the client is happy with the work and it's been signed off, it's now time to export the PDF ready for print. So the one thing you need to do before you ever send your document off to print is make 100% sure that there are no broken links or errors in your document. Images are to correct resolution and also to correct color mode. If I focus on the bottom of the screen, we have our pre-flight signal. This is here to communicate to you the status of your document. Currently, we can see this is set to green. This means there are no errors in my document. If, however, this was red, then this would indicate that there is something wrong with the document, for example, a broken link or overset text. If this is the case, then we would have to rectify any errors inside the document first. Now, it would also be wise to pay close attention to your links panel. In my links panel, I can see that each link is set to CMYK and of a resolution of 300 dpi. Always pay attention to these columns so you can see you're using adequate images for your document. If you cannot see your resolution and color mode column, then click the top right menu in the links panel, click panel options, and make sure actual PPI is checked and color spaces checked, and these will be visible. So once we have the green light, our images are set to the correct DPI and color mode, we can export the document. So I'll come up to File, scroll down and click Export. This time I'll name the file Brochure Print and make sure the format is still set to Adobe PDF Print. I'll click Save. So this time we are going to enter in some different options. So starting from the top, I'll change the PDF preset to High Quality Print. Down in Pages, I'll keep this set to All. Now this time, instead of Spreads, I'll choose Pages. I'll uncheck Optimize for Fast Web View and keep View PDF after exporting checked. For Export Layers, I'll keep Visible and Printable Layers. And next, come over to Compression. So here everything is looking fine. This is set to the best quality. So next, I'll click Marks and Bleeds. So for this, I'm simply going to click on All Printers Marks and Bleeds. If you only want to include specific marks, you can toggle these on and off. But on this occasion, I'll click them all. So down on Bleed and Slug, I'm going to click the Use Document Bleed Settings. Upon click, we will notice the value 3 appear in the top, bottom, inside and outside. Now this has appeared because we set up the bleed in the document settings when we originally created the document. If for any reason you did not set up bleed, you can simply uncheck this box and enter in a bleed value there. So I'll click back on General and make double sure my settings are correct, and I'll press Export. Upon click, InDesign will render the PDF and soon it will appear like so. So this time, we can see something quite different from the previous example. In the PDF, we now have all the necessary marks and bleeds for the printer. Now, as we scroll down the document, we will also see each page is now separated into its own page. Now you may be wondering, why are they now individual pages and not spreads like before? Well, this is a booklet brochure. This will be printed, folded, and stapled. When it comes to printing this, the pages will need to be arranged in a specific way to achieve the correct pagination when printed, stapled and folded. More on this in the next video. So let's now come to the business card. Now this is a much simpler document than the brochure, but the same rules apply. So let's go ahead and export this for print. So up to File and down to Export. I'll save this in my project folder in the PDF export. I'll name this Business Card Print. I'll make sure the format is set to PDF Print and click Save. I'll make sure PDF preset is set to High Quality Print, Pages set to All, and Pages is checked. I'll view PDF after exporting. For marks and bleeds, I'll make sure they are all checked, and the bleed is set to 3mm, and I'll click Export. And here is the business card complete with marks and guides ready for print. So finally, let's now come to the letterhead. Again, like with the business card, this is a simple document. Now earlier in the course, when we created this letterhead, we only included this type here as a guide. Now it's time to export this for print. We really need to remove the type. So over in the Layers panel, I can toggle off the Copy Guide layer, which we set up earlier. So now all I have are the elements I want to print. So let's go ahead and export this. So up to File and down to Export. I'll save this in my project folder in the PDF export. I'll name this Letterhead Print. I'll make sure the format is set to PDF Print and click Save. I'll make sure the PDF preset is set to High Quality Print. Pages are set to All and Pages is checked. I'll view PDF after exporting. For marks and bleeds, I'll make sure they are all checked. And the bleed is set to 3mm, and I'll click Export. And here is the letterhead, complete with marks and guides, ready for print. Easy! So that's how you can export PDFs in InDesign for various scenarios, for a simple preview or for high quality print. We just looked at two ways to export a PDF. Now in InDesign, there is another method of exporting so you can print a booklet for yourself at home. In InDesign, there is a feature where you can print as a booklet. Now, if you have a PDF printer installed on your computer, then you can also export a booklet PDF. In the next video, I'm going to discuss and demonstrate booklet printing in Adobe InDesign and demonstrate how to print a booklet as a PDF. See you in the next video.